As you, I think, mentioned in your introduction, in September of last year, there was a New York declaration for refugees and migrants. This was in a certain way a historic declaration in the sense that the states at the global level decided to collaborate on a framework to better manage migration in the world. How to ensure that migrants also benefit from their basic human rights? How to encourage regular migration, how to facilitate regular migration in circumstances like, for example, in Europe, where the labor market needs more migrants, but where maybe the regulations are very strict to open up places like Europe for migration. But even for the migrants that go to countries on an irregular basis, how do you make sure that kids that arrive in the country have access to education as quickly as possible? How can you work improve coordination between the country where a migrant comes from and a country where the migrant is going to, for example, when it comes to documentation? If children are born, what we have seen now, for example, in Greece, people leave one country, they get stranded in Greece, their kids are born. How do they get the nationality? How do they get their documents? These are all basic rights that migrants have. For the countries of the Western Balkans, we have the first event around the Global Compact for Migration that will take place here in Sarajevo on Thursday. It's a first for the Western Balkans, and we are trying to bring together a series of actors, government, civil society, academia, the private sector, to discuss what should be in this Global Compact for Migration. And we are going to repeat that in each country in the Western Balkans, hoping that we will by that kickstart a mm-hmm. process of national consultations around this Global Compact for Migration. Because I would like to highlight that I think the Western Balkans as a whole have a lot to contribute. Mm-hmm. Why? Because unfortunately you have the experience of forced migration with the Yugoslav wars, where you had a lot of refugees and internally displaced people. You have gained a lot of experience how to deal with that. You have experience maybe also, not maybe, also enforcement with displacement because of natural disasters like floods, for example, like you had here exactly. in Bosnia and Herzegovina. But you also have a very large diaspora. So you also have experience with people
so
that
leave
from
here.
So this
is all the knowledge that we can bring in order
Absolutely.
To adopt certain
Absolutely.
Policies.
And then you have the experience now because of the migration crisis in 2015, 2016, mm-hmm. what it means to have thousands of people from elsewhere coming into your own
your
area.
Okay,
so
exactly.
I think if you bring all
that.
Of that together, the Western Balkans really has experienced all the different facets of migration. So I think there is really a lot of experience to contribute to this global discussion on how can we improve.
And there's a lot to learn from each other,
absolutely,
I suppose.
Yes.